Hello everyone, my name is Sanjay Singh. Welcome to my course Java Fundamentals, the Java language. In this module, I am going to teach you writing a first Java applications program. So basically in this module, we will see how you can write your first Java applications program, how you can write the program and execute this using the command line argument. So in this module, what you can expect? You will learn writing your first Java program, executing from the command line argument. You will see also about the Java statements, what are the types of statements, how you can write the statements. You will also learn about the comments in Java, how is the comment important, how you should write the comments for each and every functionality you are writing in the code. You will also see the demo, how you can write the comments in the code and how you should ideally follow. I will also teach about the details about the package. I am not go much into the details. In the later module, we will see the many more program about the packages. But in this module, I will just give you the overview idea about the packages. We will also see how you can write the package and using the Java code. And at the end of the session, you will learn how to write a program using the IDE and how you can execute this. So let's write your first Java applications program. Okay, but before writing this, you need to follow some rule. Okay, the rule is not much difficult to remember. So remember those days when you are learning the car or learning the how to ride the bike. So there was some rule you need to follow, how you can apply the clutch, how you can apply the brake, how you should frequently using the changing the gear and all. So once you had get expertise, you was not required to remember all these rules, when you need to change the gear, at what speed you need to change the gear, and what is the purpose of the clutch, brake and gear and all. So the same way, the rule is not very restricted for Java. So while you are writing your first Java program, or if you are writing the big program, this basic rule you always need to remember. So let's see what is the rule. Thereafter we will write the first Java applications. So the first rule says, in Java every application starts with a class definition and the name of class should match the file name in the Java. Okay, means whatever your class name is you are defining, the same should be the name of the Java file. Okay, thereafter the main method, you just need to remember public static void main method. We will later on see what is the meaning of public static void main and string args, but for now you just need to remember this method, and every application Java must contain this method if you are going to execute your Java program. Third rule say, the main method must be inside the class definition. If you are writing the main method, the same method outside the class, there is no meaning, because in Java, in a small or big program, you cannot write any single line of code without any class. So the main method must be inside the class definition if you want to going to execute or write the Java application. Okay, the Java compiler executes the code starting from the main method. Basically, the main method is the entry point of the Java, from where JVM starts the compiling and executing the code. So that you need to remember this rule. So once you get expertise, once you started writing the code, okay, you will have experience, you will get expertise, so you don't required to to remember the rule every time. So let's go and create our first program, okay, and then we will execute this program using the command line argument. So I will be using here Notepad plus editor. This is the freeware. If you want to use as editor, you can also go to the web browser and download this Notepad++. So some programs we will be writing this code. Later on we will see how we can write the code using the IDE. So we will be start using the IDE, but for now let's write a first Java program, your first Java program using the plain editor like Notepad++, and see how we can execute this using the command line argument. So the first rule was the class definition. So I am writing one class hello world, okay, curly braces open, curly braces closed. So the class definition is done. This is how you can define the class. Thereafter, the main method from where the JVM or the Java starts compiling or starts executing. So it was public static void main string args. Args is the variable, we will see later on, but for now you just need to remember these things you will have to write. Okay. So this main method should be inside the class. So this rule is also we are following up. So basically this is the, you know, the Java applications without any, you know, without any output providing, without any output, this will, if you compile this code, this will compile successfully but will not give any output because you have not written any statement inside this class file or inside this method. Okay, so let's write some statement. System dot out dot println. In Java, every statement ends with semicolon. Okay, so this is the semicolon I have given. So this is my first Java application. Hello world. Okay, so this is the one statement I have written. So now your hello world application is ready. This application will show you, this is my first Java applications to the console or to the client. Okay, and the third rule was whatever the class name you are providing here, the same name should be your the Java file name. So let's go and save the file name of this your Java. Okay, so let's go there, F drive. Okay, Sanjay user, then Java. Okay, sorry, Java and first let me go there using this way. I'm not going to save this. Go to F drive, then Sanjay user, then Java, then create your own folder. First program, okay, and save here. What should be the file name of the Java class? Java file hello world, because the class name is hello world, the same name should be appear here and it's case sensitive, so you need to take very careful. So here H is caps, here H is caps. If H is caps here and if you are putting H small here, it won't want to compile. It will give you a message, hello world, not able to recognize, and save. So we have saved the Java file with name hello world.java and the name is same as with the class name. So now our Java file is ready. We have created our first applications program. And then let's go to command line and run the program from there. Okay, so command line means what? Command line is the prompt. So let's go to the, you know, the command line cmd. Okay, we have saved the file in the F drive, Sanjay user, Java, first program hello world dot Java. Okay, so let's go there, F drive, sorry, F drive cd sanjay user /java / we have created first program. First program, okay. Now we are into the first program. If you see what are the files there, only one file is there called hello world.java. So inside this folder, first program, we have a only one file, Java file called hello world.java. Okay. Then we will execute here. Basically, we will compile this Java program using the command line argument. So, for compiling the Java applications, what is the command? Java C. Okay. Java C is not present in this first program. Still, this will be recognized by our operating system. How? Because we have set the environment variable when we had installed the JDK. Okay, so in the previous module we had seen how you can download the JDK, okay, how you can set the, you know, environment variable. So let me repeat you where you can see the, your environment variable. Go to the my computer, right click, okay, can go to the advanced system setting, okay, go to the environment variable, okay, and go to the path, okay, edit. You can see I had set the variable C drive, program file, Java, JDK and bin. So this is the place where we had installed the JDK, and bin is the directory basically with all the binary executable of the Java file are present. Okay. Okay, come back to the command line argument. Okay. So here also, if you want to check if the Java environment variable is set or not, then you can check also, type the path, okay, then you can see what all the environment variable has been set for this operating system, okay. So at the end of this path, you can see C drive, program file, Java, JDK, bin. So you don't need to, you know, to give the path every time of this location and execute the Java C command. So let's compile this first, Java C. And what was your program name, application name? Hello world.java. So hello world.java. So what will it will do? Java C, Java compiler will compile this code and create a class file. Okay. So let's do this. Okay. So it's giving some error. See what is the error. So we have done some typing mistake, okay, let's go to the program, okay. So the rule was not this, it was like this, okay. Save it, okay. Now go to the command line argument and again execute program Java C hello world.java, okay. Then press enter. Okay, see there is no any warning or any error came. If you go to the folder, let's go to the folder, okay, then dir, okay, if you see the other file is also present called hello world.java, okay. If you go to the folder, basically go here, drive g user and first program. If you see here, earlier there was only one file, now we have your hello world class. So basically, once your applications compile successfully, JVM, Java Virtual Machine or Java creates a class file corresponding to the Java file, and basically these class files are the input of JVM, okay, where JVM is installed, okay. This class file will be treated as an input of the JVM, and this will be treated as a bytecode of the, you know, the file, and this will take the Java file as an input and it will execute Java. When the, you know, JVM executes the code, it does not considers the dot Java file, it considers only the dot class file, okay. Then go to the command line. So we have a hello world.java. So for executing the file, we have a Java, okay, then hello world, okay. So while executing the first applications hello world, you don't need to provide the extension dot class or dot Java, okay. Your final applications name is hello world. So Java is the command present in the bin directory where we have set the environment variable. Okay, so I am going to press this. So see, this is my first Java application, Hello World. So Java is executed the Hello World applications and it provides you the output. This is my first Java applications Hello World program. Okay, so now I think you have learned this, how you can write your first Java applications, how you can go to the command line argument and how you can write your first Java program. So for now you have learned how you can create your first applications in Java, how you can run these applications using the command line argument. So you need to practice this. So let's move ahead. Okay, so now we have learned this, running Java applications from the command line argument. Okay, so now come to the Java statement. So a statement in Java can be either simple statement, like we write system.out.println, that is a simple statement. Okay, or it can be compound statement if you are using the multiple thing like while loop or for loop or if a statement. So it becomes the complex structure, okay, which are sometimes also called the control structure, like while loop or if conditions or the for loop. These are the control structure because these are the, you know, the statements which controls the flow of your program. So these are the statements basically. Okay, so how you can define the statements? Like in the our last first Java applications program, we write a system.out.println to show this is my first Java applications program. Let's go there. Okay, so if you see here, our first application was here. So if you see here in a Java file, this system.out.println is a one of the statement, and every statement ends with a semicolon. So in like the same way, you can write the multiple statements like here. You can write the multiple statements, like if you are assigning any variable like int a is equal to 10. Okay, this is also one statement. Okay, so you can say the collection of a statement is your one program or is a program execution statement. Okay, so the statement can be your simple statement, or if you are using the while loop, for loop or some other conditional statement, it can be your complex statement, you can say. Okay, so this is all about your statement part. So this are considered as a statement. Okay, so if I write this code, int a equal to 10, this is the another statement, this is the first statement. So this is how you can create the statement, multiple statements in a code. Okay, so now part to the comments. So statements and comments are different. Okay, a statement is for writing your code inside the class file. Okay, it can be your single line statement, it can be a multiple line statement. So comments are basically intended for the person reading the code for the better understanding and to understand the functionality of a program. One person in a big, you know, the big program, applications program, one person writing the code and switch to the other, you know, other project. Some other person comes, the other person should understand the functionality of the program and the readability of the program. So basically whenever you're writing some logics or comment or some statements, so we write some comments about the functionality of the program. Okay, and these basically comments are not considered by the Java compiler. When you are compiling the program, JVM does not consider this, or when you are running the program, JVM doesn't consider this. So in Java programming language there are two types of comments. Okay, this is the legacy comments, which also we are getting used in a C or C++. Okay, and the other is the end of line comments. Basically this is the for the one line comments that we can write. Okay, so this is the our traditional comments. If you are writing anything between these two things, slash star and star slash, then all these things will be treated as a comments, and the Java compiler will not consider that part of the code, or you can say the statement. And this is the basically single line statement. If you want to put only single line statement, end of line comments, this is said in a Java, you can use this. Okay, so let's go and see how you can use this. Okay, go to our earlier program. Okay, so this is our first program. Okay, so let's think I am writing comments here. Let's see. Okay, so whatever I am writing between these two, this will be treated as a comment and Java compiler will not consider. Okay, you can either write in a single line or a multiple line. So I am writing, this is my first program. Then thereafter I am putting another line and putting nice to execute first program. Okay, so if you have written this two line under this, so this will be treated as a comment and the Java compiler will not consider this. I am also putting here comment in a single line comment, like declaring a integer variable, okay, and assigning this to 10. So anyone, if you are opening this, you know, application, he would be able to understand this system dot out println purpose is to just give the demo of the first program and to execute the first program. Anybody can listen, understand this, why the a variable has got declared. Okay, and you can write the purpose, any purpose you can write here, any purpose you can write here. Okay, so but this is a single line. If you are writing something here, this is not going to compile. We will see here. So I saved this file, then go to the command line. So you have modified this file here, so you have to again compile this file. So for compilation, the command was java c hello world.java. Okay, compiled successfully. Then java hello world, this is the command to execute this. Oh, see, compiler has not considered the any comment that we have given in the code. Okay, but if you are using the single line and thereafter you crossed that line and came to the another line and putting here, this is written by Sanjay, okay, and saved it. Okay, and then go to the command line argument and okay, java c hello world dot java. Okay, see here I am going to compile this again because you have changed the code. See, Java throws the error. Okay, it throws the error. What error? This is written by Sanjay. If you see, it's pointing here, this is the error. Okay, why it's throwing an error? Because this is a statement is not following the rule and this should be treated as a comment. If you are treating as a comment, again put this, sorry, put this as a statement. This is the written by Sanjay. So compiler will treat as a first single line statement, this is the second single line statement. So now it will compile successfully. Go here, java c hello world java. See, it's compiled, no error, means compiled successfully. Okay, then java hello world java, your application got run and it's providing the how, this is my first Java applications program hello world. Okay, so you can see how you can, you know, provide the comments, single line comments or multiple line comments in a Java code. ओके. नाउ द पैकेजेज, इंट्रोडक्शन पैकेजेज. बेसिकली ए पैकेज इज कलेक्शन ऑफ रिलेटेड क्लासेस. बेसिकली इफ यू आर हैव ए मल्टीपल क्लासेस विद अ डिफरेंट पर्पस, देन यू कैन अरेंज द सेम टाइप ऑफ क्लासेस इन वन फोल्डर और वन पैकेज, यू कैन से. सो बेसिकली इट हेल्प्स ऑर्गेनाइज योर क्लासेस इन अ फोल्डर स्ट्रक्चर एंड मेक इट ईजी टू लोकेट एंड यूज देम. मोर इम्पोर्टेंटली इट हेल्प्स इम्प्रूव रीयूजेबिलिटी. ईच पैकेज इन जावा हैज इट्स यूनिक नेम एंड ऑर्गेनाइज इट्स क्लासेस एंड इंटरफेसेस इन टू ए सेपरेट नेम स्पेस और नेम ग्रुप. यू कैन से इट्स सेपरेट नेम स्पेस और द ग्रुप और द पैकेज ऑल आर सिनोनिम्स ओनली. द पर्पस इज टू इजिली एक्सेस एंड लोकेट द क्लास जावा क्लास फाइल. आई एम गिविंग द वन एग्जाम्पल इन अ विंडोज हाउ यू क्रिएट सम डिफरेंट फोल्डर. इफ यू आर गोइंग ऑन द ट्रिप यू क्रिएट अ सेपरेट योर इमेजेज इन अ सेपरेट ट्रिप फोल्डर देन अदर फोल्डर. इफ यू गो टू द ऑल्सो हियर लाइक इफ यू गो टू द एनी फोल्डर लाइक सी लेट्स गो टू द सी ड्राइव and program files. Okay, so basically these are the system file. We are assume like different folders are there. Okay, then why different folders are there? Because we can locate where you have kept the particular file in which folder. Okay, same kind of file we have popped into the one folder. So basically these are the packages. You can consider this the packages. Okay, if you are going to the Windows NT, okay, then accessories, then same kind of package UFC has kept inside the folder. So the same way, okay, if you are writing a multiple Java class file and the 10 class file belongs to some specific purpose and other 10 classes are, you know, belongs to some other purpose, then you can define and put the classes file inside some separate package. And it helps the reusability of the code. Basically, if you want to, you know, to access the class name, basically the Java file, to multiple places, then you don't need to require the same Java code in multiple places. You can access that Java. You can go to the packages and access that. Then how you will go to the package? How you will understand? You don't need to, you know, the search the all folder of the file. If you are, you don't, you know, the basically the package or the folder name where you have kept, you can go there and access this. So this is the basically the purpose of the package, and there is a multiple benefits. We see the what is the multiple benefits, what is the advantage of Java packages. So first benefit is Java package is used to categorize the classes and interfaces so that they can be easily maintained. In the later on, we'll see what is classes, what is interfaces, when we should use the classes and when we should use the interfaces. They are two separate things. But for now, just remember, if we are creating the class, all the classes means the Java class file will be putting into the one folder, one package. The interfaces kinds of file will be put into the different packages. Okay, so packages is nothing here. Packages is basically a folder or the group which you will be creating and putting the same kind of file inside that package. Okay, you can also, you know, protect these files using the Java packages. We will see the later on how you can protect the file. You don't want to access this particular Java file across or outside. How you can protect this, you can see. So Java packages removes the naming collision. So there may be situations in thousands Java files, then the two Java files will have a same name. Okay, then there may be a collision which Java files should a particular application should call. But if the two Java files are inside the different packages, okay, then there will be no collision. If I know XYZ is the one package and the other ABC is another package, then I can call this the same Java file using your package name. So there will be no collision. And as I explained to you, packages provides the reusability of the code. Okay, if the same code, the same program need to use in the other applications, you can go, you can access the Java code using the packages, and then you can reuse the code. And to bundle the classes and interfaces, obviously if you are putting all classes, you can make in the bundle, you can shift this bundle to the other applications and you can use this. Either it's your own package or it's inbuilt package. Okay, like if there is a Java providing some packages, you can use that package and you can use your program, and or you can create our own package. So there is java.util package where some method has been defined and has given to you. So Java has given some thousands of package, so you don't need to write the same package as the code has been given by the Java. You just need to, you know, to import that package, means to use this package, and you can use the methods or inbuilt methods or inbuilt functionality, or you can create our own package. You will see how you can create your own package. This is the I will teach you about the basic idea about the package. You will have a separate module called package where we'll write the main program and we'll see the more functionality about the package. Okay, so let's see, just create one package and we'll in our first Java applications program and see how we can use this. So let's go and create our own package. So we'll create our own package here. Let's go to our first written simple program where we had written our first program. So it was okay. So this was our first program. So if you are creating the package in a Java, then the syntax is we'll have to write package package and give the package name. So let's see, I am giving the package name called pack pack. Okay, so this is the package name. I am typing comment here also, this is a package name. Okay, this is the package name, then semicolon you have to put. So under this package, okay, this hello world class file will get created. So if you are compiling this class Java file, then the hello world.class file will created, and that class file will be under this package pack. So we will see how it will looks like. For now, just see how you can declare your own package, how can you create your own package, and what will happen if you are compiling this code, this Java hello world code. So save this. Okay, and then go to the your command line argument from where you can, you know, generate the code or compile the code and class and how you can run the applications. Then let's go there. So here is our last program, hello world.java, and thereafter when we had executed this or compiled this code, hello world.class was created. So if you see right now inside this folder, there are two files only, hello world.java and hello world.class, which was had got generated last time when we had compiled our Java code. Okay, so we see here how you can define the package, and let's now compile this package. Okay, so if we are going to execute the command line argument only, so if you are using the command line argument, you just need to remember one thing: Java C is the compilation, you will have to provide minus d basically when you are using the packages. Okay, minus d dot current means dot means the current folder where you have kept the Java file. Otherwise, if your Java file in some other location, you can give the path of that location here instead of dot. Okay, thereafter hello world dot java. Okay, when I will press the enter, okay, the Java will compile the code and see what it happens. Enter. Okay, there is no warning, no error message, means Java compiler compiles the hello world.java successfully. Okay, let's go to the folder and see. See this class file, earlier there was only two file. Now if you see, there is one folder has got created, okay, and inside that folder the class has got created. So if you are writing some 100 Java file and top of the every Java file, okay, if you are putting here package pack, then all the class file after the compilation will be put, Java will put inside this pack folder, okay, like here pack folder. This is the older one. If you delete this, doesn't matter, okay, we are not going to that class file. We are always going to use this class file which are inside this pack folder. So this is how you can create a package, okay. So we will later on also see how you can use this package in the multiple places, but for now just see how you can create the package, okay. And we will also later on see how you can use this package using the import statement. So for now don't need to bother about this, I am giving you just overview. So learn here how you can create your own package and how the classes are put inside the package folder, okay. Let's now creating and running applications using the Eclipse IDE. So far we had seen how you can, you know, create an applications using the any editor, in a plain editor, and how you can run that applications using the command line argument. Here we will see how you can write the applications using the Eclipse IDE, okay. So let's go there Eclipse and see. So now I am using this, let me close this out all, okay. So this is the Eclipse editor. I think I had given you the overview in the our last module. So I don't need to give you the what is the Eclipse editor and how you should use, okay. I have already given you, but while using this editor, you know where you need to go to the file, then new, okay, then Java project. So give the project name like hello world, hello world, okay. Keep this all as it is. We had also seen JDK, what is JRE. We had also seen how you can download this Eclipse editor in the previous module. If you have not very much sure, then you can go back to our previous module video, and then you can learn how you can download the Eclipse, how you can install the Eclipse, and what are the details about the Eclipse. Next, okay, and then finish, okay. See, hello world application has created and source has created here. Folder, this is the Eclipse editor has got generated the source folder, okay. Now you have just created the hello world folder, basically application's name. You have to just create one Java file. So you are going to create one class. So before that, if you are not creating a package, the Eclipse will give you default package name, default default. So better create a one package, and package name called can be pack like our earlier one, okay, then finish, okay. So you can see package has got created. So inside that package, okay, I am also creating one class file, okay. And what should be your class file name? Hello world should be caps, hello world, okay. And public static void main, as I explained in the earlier session, like the main method should be inside the class name and it's compulsory, okay. Finish, okay. See, Eclipse had created this, you don't need to write the manually. Earlier you had seen I had written this code manually, okay, but using the Eclipse editor you don't need to write the code, okay. So he had given you the code here, package name also it's created, file is also created, okay. So all the things he has created, the stuff, you just need to write system.out.println, okay, and you have to write this is my first simple application and hello world. Okay, so see how this eclipse saves our efforts. We have to write this only one. Okay, and also we don't need to go save it from the file, and you can save. Okay, or you can press the Control S to save this. So now our code is ready. See how frequently you created your class and write the code. So basically this gives the, you know, the flexibility to the programmer to concentrate more on the statement side, to the business logic side, instead of, you know, creating the skeleton of the class, managing a folder, which Java file should go to the which package and all. So this editor takes care of all these things. So I have written this. So now I have to execute this program. Okay, compile this program. Okay, so for compilation, if you are not using the Eclipse editor, you need to go to the command line argument. You will have to execute the Java C command, then thereafter Java command to, you know, to provide to and to get the output. So here you don't need to do anything. Okay, just go to the, in the run. If you know the shortcut Ctrl+11, then you can press this. Otherwise, run menu bar, go to this run. Okay, and see here your code run, and it's provided there. This is the console part. So this is the my first sample applications hello world. So you got the output. So you created the Java file, you compiled the Java file, and you executed the Java file within a 2 minute. So see how the Eclipse editor is giving you the things and providing the things very, you know, very efficient way, and you don't need to put your the efforts to writing the skeleton of the program. Okay, so this is the how you can use the Eclipse editor for writing your first Java applications. Okay, so as long as we will moving to the program, we'll come to know. I will teach you more about the Eclipse editor, how you can debug the things using the Eclipse editor, how you can, you know, how you can use the another tool with Eclipse editor. So we'll come to know more about these things as soon as we start moving about our next topic. So I hope you have got understand how you can write your first applications program. Okay, using this Eclipse editor. So this was all about this module. So I hope you have learned about how you can create about your first Java applications program in a simple editor, how you can run your applications using the command line argument, what is the statement, what should be the structure of the statement, okay, what is the simple statement, what is the control statement, complex statement. You have understood in this module. We also learned about the comments, what is the single line comment, what you can write the multiple line comment, what is the benefit of the comment. You also learned about the basic idea about the packages, how you can create the package. Okay, how packages, you know, arrange the folders. And thereafter, at the end of the session, we learned how to create and running applications using the Eclipse IDE. So I hope you have learned the basic idea about the creating your first applications program. So this is all about this model. Thank you.